Before we start this video, I would like to take a moment to say thanks to all my patrons. I wouldn't be able to keep doing these videos without you guys, so thank you so much for all your support. It means so much to me. I would also like to say thanks to Code Gorilla, Richter and Joshua for their tier 3 sub, and special thanks to James, Michael, Justin and Sean for their tier 4 sub this month. In the last video we managed to set up our grid, and in this video we're going to make sure that we can manipulate with that grid by clicking the tiles. So to do that we can create a new script. So go to scripts folder and right click create and find the C# script and make a Astar script. So this script is also going to run our algorithm later. We can go to create and create an empty game object and call this game object Astar, and then add the Astar script to it. This script needs to be opened up because we need to change or add some functionality to it. First of all, we need to add a tile type. We could do this with integers instead of an enumeration, but I think it's easier to read when we write it out as a an enumeration. So public enum and tile type, and then you write in all the types of tiles you have. Start, goal, blocked, that's our water, so let's call it water. Grass, path. So these are the types that we can have. Then we need to make a tile type here, private tile type. So this one is going to decide whether what type we're going to place. So if this one is start, it's going to place start, and if it's gold, it's going to place gold, and so on. We need to be able to click our tile map. So we need to go to update. I don't think we need start for now. And update, we check if we have an input. Get mouse button down, and if we click mouse left mouse, if we click the mid left mouse, then we want to create a raycast. Then we also say raycasts, see a raycast hit 2D, physics 2D, somewhere there, and then we raycast. Where do you want to raycast? We want to raycast on our main camera. So let's make a private camera called camera, and let's use that camera here. Dot screen point to world. Screen to world point, that's what it's called. Input on our mouse position. Just want to create a raycast on our mouse position because we have our game here, and where I have my mouse is the point where I want to throw a ray into the world so I can hit this tile. And when I have selected that, I would also like to set the direction to vector2.0, and I want to run it the distance math infinity. And we could also add a mask to it, actually. Let's do that. Let's add a mask. Let's see here, up here. Private layer mask. And we can just take and serialize this field here and serialize this field here. There we go. Okay. So now we need to set these up in the inspector, of course, but we have our raycast here, and we need to add in the layer mask like that. Oops, not that one. It's just called mask, so layer. That's why I can't find it. There. Okay, so now I'm trying to hit a raycast on a specific layer. We'll set up the layer in Unity in a second. And what's going to happen then? Well, if I hit something, because we're going to have that layer, we don't need to check what we hit. So if my hit.collider isn't null, this means that I hit something in my game world. If that's the case, we say vector3 mouse world position is equal to camera dot screen to world point input dot mouse position. So we need to get the mouse world position. then we can say vector3 int. So what is a vector3 int? Well, it's an integer that contains a vector3 in Unity. And the reason we're using vector3 int is because that's the data type that our tilemaps are operating on. They use vector3 int to decide the position of something. So it has a vector3 int, right? So this one position here would be 0.0, for example. And this one would be 1.0, and this one would be 2.0, and so on. So that's why we're using vector3, and that's the one. So click position, and then we need to add, get in touch, or get our tile map. So we can also go up here and make a private tile map. Isn't that how it is with non-capital M? Right-click, quick actions, and implement using in the engine the tilemaps, and call tilemap. And let's also serialize this because it's easier for us to set up in the inspector. Remember, all this is actually just for debugging, and for not for debugging though, but for setting up our map. It's not part of the actual Astar though. And then when we've done that, we can say tilemap dot world to cell. So we take a world position, and we just got a world position from our camera. I think so, world to Celsius. And we take our mouse world position there. So now we have actually grabbed a position of a cell. And we can use that position to set a tile. And to do that, we can create a function, or we can just check if it works. Let's make a function. Let's make a private function called change tile, and it takes in a vector3 in click position. So that's the position where we want to change the tile to something else. And what do we need to change the tile into? Well, we need to change it into whatever tile type we have set up here. So let's just try to write tile map. Dot set tile, click position, and what tile do we need to set? Well, we need to have an array of tiles somehow with all the tiles in. So we need to go up here and let's make a private tile array called tiles and serialize that and save. So now we have our tiles, so we can basically say click position tiles. Let's just take index 0 for now. And then we go up here and say we want to change tile or click position. Okay, so we can save this, and we can set this up in what's called the in Unity editor. And then we can check if all this works. So let's jump into Unity and let's set this up. Let's select our Astar here. And then we need the tile map. The tile map is under our grid. We can grab it and put it there. Then we have all our tiles. And we actually need to create some extra tiles here. We have grass and so on, but let's create one more. Actually, we can duplicate them, I guess. We need grass, start, goal, water. So grass, start. We have a goal, and we have water. That's those four we need. And just make sure when you select them that you have the right tiles. So let's click here and write start. Select that one up and take, oops, that was goal though. So set goal up on that, click the start one and set the start up and water, and then just select water. Oops, zero, I guess it's called, this one. We will set the other waters up later, and that's a separate video, because if you don't want to implement different water with, implement the water where it creates a river and they fit correctly together, then you can skip that video, because it has nothing to do with Astar, nothing to do with pathfinding. It's just something extra to use in this tutorial to set it up so it looks nice, right? It's a rule tile we're going to use, and you can skip that video later if it's not interesting for you. Anyway, we have all these tiles, and we need to select our tile map, and our Astar. And here we can say we have four tiles. Let's write four. So zero could be water, for example. or grass or whatever we want. Let's type water. And we need to set make sure that our tile map here, add component and write tile map collider. There's a collider on it now. It doesn't really matter if it's a trigger or not. We need to add a layer, so click add layer and write tile map. This is our tile map layer. Select the tile map again and set the layer up to tile map layer. Then you select the Astar and you say the layer mask it's going to hit is the tile map. So we only raycast towards the tile map. So based on this, we should be able to get that. Okay, the camera is not set up. So we select the camera here. It's none. Take your main camera and drag it onto that camera there. And I think, let's see, do we need to set more up? We have tile type. It's by default start though. We're not using that right now. Tile map is set up. Tiles, camera, layer mask. Okay. So everything should have been set up correctly. We can test now and see if it actually works. So we can click to create these and you can see something is horribly wrong. Let's see. Let's select the canvas first of all and make sure the canvas is set to scale with screen size. Okay. As you'll see, the buttons will disappear so you can't click them. So we need to move them back in. You can move them back in like this. Then select all the buttons here and we can set a size to 40 maybe. Yeah, I guess that size is maybe a little better, maybe 50. And then of course we need to select our images as well and scale them down with us. So select all of them. There, so select all the images and let's see, the scale should be say 0.5 instead. Little 0.7. Yeah, so 0.7 for all of them in my case at least. There we go. Now you'll need to reset the position, so select buttons and you can adjust the top here so it fits there, and the spacing can be adjusted right there, and also you can also adjust the lift the right side if you want it to be a little more out. So you just need to adjust. Oh, we are still missing one button here, so let's see here, top shouldn't be like that, it should be like that. And then the spacing, to be adjusted, we also need the debugging, of course. There, I'm pretty happy with the setup. Okay, so when you have adjusted it, you can try to maximize and play again. And now the buttons should have the same position as they had before when you didn't have maximize and play. Anyway, we need to select our sprites and find all our water tiles. Select all of them and set the pixels per unit to 300 and click apply. And when you have done that, you should be able to click around on the map and put what's called water on the map without any problems now, without big sprites. So we can jump back into the script and set something up. We can make sure we can use our tile type. So if you, instead of writing serial, you can write tile type. Not sure if it's going to cast itself. It is. So we can use the tile. Nope, it's not. So let's just cast it to an integer right there. The reason that we can cast it to an integer is because there's an underlying data type here, which is actually, I think it's a byte standard. So this one is 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. That's how it is. And we can use that now. So 0, what is that? That's start. So it will place, if I save this, it should just place start everywhere. Oops, not start, of course, because it's just reset 0, so we need to put it in the right order. Let's go here to grid, find our A star, and find our tiles. 4. So water is 0. Let's put it in the right order here. Let's say start, gold, water, grass, path. So find our tiles. So start, water. What was it? Start, gold, water, grass. I can't even remember. 2 seconds. Start, gold, water, grass. Of course, you can change this if you want to. Path, we don't have a path, do we? Nope. So let's make a path here. And change the sprite to, I think it's called path, yeah, there. Okay. And let's have 5 here and set path as that one. Okay, so we start, go water, grass. Not water one, but path. Okay, I don't know why it will call that water. Let's see, 4, 5. Okay, so I'll try to delete this. If you have that problem, delete the path, right click, create tiles, a star tile, and call it path. Seems like it was remembering what it was before. There we go. And then select the path and set up the sprite. Because now we have all them. So now it should just put start everywhere. And it does. So it puts start everywhere. We need to set it up so these buttons here knows what they need, what to place. We can do this with an integer. We can also just make a script called tile button. Here on the tile button, if it would like to open it up, we need to make a private enum. What do we call it? A tile type, I guess. And we serialize this, and then we make a property. We don't need to set it, we just need to get it and rename it to my tile type and save that. And then we go to our A-star, our A-star, and we say pop void change tile type, and it takes in a tile button. And then we say my tile type. Oh, tile type is the same as button dot my tile type. So now we can use change tile type to change the tile type. And we need to go back to Unity, open up our canvas, select all our buttons here. Here, click the little plus and say that we take in A star and A star. Change tile type. We need to take in the button, so we need add component, add a tile button to all of them, and then we need to set it up. So start, of course, a start. Goal needs to be goal. Water needs to be water. Grass needs to be grass. And let's start. Where do we have? We have path somewhere. That's, oh, we don't have path, of course, because we shouldn't be able to click path, because the path is generated by using the Astar algorithm. So we can actually go to our grid, our Astar, and remove the last one. So do this. So it's 4. I'll keep the path, because we also need it later when we need to generate the path. So now we should be able to do like this. Here, set start. It's not reacting. Oops, I forgot to do something, I guess. Let's see here. We have our canvas buttons. We didn't put something in, so we need to say start. Takes in, needs to add itself, so we need to add the button. Where's the button script there? Goal, we need to take the button script there. Water, we need to take its own button script. And grass. Yeah. And step complete reset. They don't need, really need this, so select reset step and complete. And we actually need to remove this, I guess, and remove the A star on click, because we don't need to change the tile type there. So we can just click none. Let's try again. I can click there and click here. So now I can change what tiles we're placing in our game world. And I can remove them again by doing this. So now we can actually change our grid. That's what I want to do in this video. In the next video, we will try to make the water nicer. You can skip the next video if you're not interested in learning about the rule tile, because it has nothing to do with A-star. It's just the thing that makes this look a little nicer for us when we start playing around with A-star. So thank you very much for watching.
Thanks for watching my video. Please remember that InScope Studios is a community-founded page, so please consider clicking the support link on the screen to see how you can support me and get something back in return.